I'm investigating Class D audio amplification, and for that I'm using a little Hercules microcontroller, and it's both the digital audio source and the Class D amplifier.
Classic digital analog setup, you have a CD player or an MP3 player, and the output of that is already analog. So all the things downstream from your source is analog. And that comes with a cost in energy, because analog devices, analog amplifiers, typically have an efficiency of 50% and less. You are burning a lot of energy in the amplifier instead of sending them to the speakers. In a Class D setup, things are different, because there the output of your source is still digital. So it sends a digital signal to your preamp. The preamp can be a computer or a digital signal processor. And then you send that to a digital amplifier, a switch mode amplifier. And the only thing that it does is convert the pulse width module signals that are maybe 3 volt, 3 or 1 volt and a bit inside your computer or inside your digital signal processor. It turns that into a high energy switched signal, so maybe 40, 50 volts, but it's still binary because it's only high and low, but there is a lot of energy under here. And that energy is then in the filter turned into analog signal with that same energy, so you have 90% or more efficiency here. And because in a switched mode amplifier, where you have a half bridge where there's only one transistor at a single time working and it's delivering power, the other transistor is blocked, so it's not consuming power, it means that all your power goes to the filter and to the speaker, so there is almost no loss inside this module, inside the digital amplifier. I told in the beginning that everything runs on this Hercules launchpad. The digital signal is generated inside the high-end timer of that launchpad, and then the GPIO outputs are used as D-class amplifier. And at the end, I filter this with two Jelly Bean components, a resistor and a capacitor. It's better that you do that with a coil and a capacitor, but for this low power of my design, it doesn't really matter. Let's have a look at the signals. The top yellow signal you see here is the digital output. So that is the amplified Class D signal. And then the lower signal is after the filter. That is the analog amplified signal that can go to your speakers. Because I'm using the output of a microcontroller here, it will not be very high energy, but you get the point.